Okay, good.
So everything was handed to him on a silver platter. When he was six, Buddy Mark wanted to go to a basketball game. His father paid the starting five of the Bulls and the Celtics to play a private game of Nerf ball in Buddy Mark's bedroom. So his dad did what? Played two.
New or exciting in his life.
Just what you wanted, and sometimes you get things and sometimes you don't. What does that teach you as a person, Tommy?
It doesn't depend on what you want, it depends on what you have.
Because happiness doesn't depend on what?
Well.
Happiness doesn't depend on physical things. Happiness depends on
your
heart, right? And who's around you. Okay, go ahead.
You can't buy.
There's a cliche line. That's the hit the theme on it. Money does not buy happiness. Because what did money buy for what's his name? Money Mark? Money bought him all kinds of physical things, but was he happy by the time he was 21?
Nope.
And then here's this girl who, she couldn't go to a Pacers or a game, right? Celtics game. What did her dad do instead? He couldn't afford to take her to the game, but he took her to the stadium. They walked around the outside. You still could feel the excitement and energy of the game, right? So money doesn't always buy happiness, does it?
Okay,
let's
see.
Okay,
that is
the theme. And then you're going to give me a detail in that story. Now, when I'm asking for a detail, I'm asking you for quoting word for word a sentence in that story. No.
Okay.
You are looking for something and tying it together. So what would be a detail that you could tie together? Money Mark had everything bought for him.
Okay.
But he grew up and was not
happy.
Yeah.
Penny Poor didn't get everything she wanted. Penny Petal. Poor Penny. What did I say?
Penny Poor.
Was like, I can't buy everything that I want. I don't get everything I want, but I know I'm still loved, and that makes me feel happy.
Hey, all this talking shows me that you're done and ready for the third one.
Yeah.
Oh, then you should not be talking. You should be right. Wasn't too strict about deadlines, and Sammy took advantage of that. He did all of his homework in his other classes, but never bothered to complete Mr. Morton's reading assignments, figuring that he could complete them later. Tammy, on the other hand, completed each assignment Mr. Morton assigned the night that he assigned it. He had to stay up a little later but she didn't want to get a penalty for turning in her reading work late. Tammy knew reading was a core subject and that she had to keep a C average for the entire year or she would have to go to summer school. When the end of the quarter came, Tammy and Sammy had both planned on going to the Enchanted Castle amusement park. But Mr. Borton called Sammy's mother and she grounded Sammy until he turned in all of his work. That weekend was horrible for Sammy.
I got it. Okay.
He stayed up until 2 a.m. each night and still couldn't complete all of the assignments. The whole while, Tammy had a great time eating pizza at the Enchanted Castle, watching movies late at night, and advantage of Miss Bunch because maybe she's like super nice teacher and she's like, yeah, okay, I'll give you a mark, but you know what happens if you take advantage of somebody who is letting you kind of slide? Yes. What happens? It ends up you're giving yourself the consequence, aren't you? So the life lesson is don't take advantage of other people's kindness, right? Because what happened at the end of the story? What happened at the end of the story? Joya. One, he got in trouble and he totally missed his school trip. But two, what else happened with his grade? He barely got a C minus. And the only reason he got that C minus was because why? Because his teacher contacted his mama and his mama grounded him and forced him to do that. But you think if teacher wouldn't have contacted his mama and mama wouldn't have made him do the work, would he have done that work on his own?
No.
Nope. And do you think he would have gotten that C minus? What do you think he would have gotten? F. So be responsible. The life lesson is this. Be responsible if you want things to happen. Don't take advantage of people, but be responsible if you want good things to happen. If you are like, I really don't care what grade I get.
Yeah.
You should.
Because if you don't care, fifth grade, woo, you ain't gonna make it through middle, high school, college. You still got three sections of schooling to go. You've only completed, when older is better, you'll like it. It's hard when you're little babies. You guys aren't babies. I'm talking about like the kindergartners or first graders and second graders. You guys are at that age where like I personally think you guys should be like an intermediate school, not in an elementary school. I think fifth and sixth and seventh should be together. Or fifth through eighth should be together.
Yes, fifth through eighth should be together.
You wait. Yeah. I will come and see you. I will come and see you at the start of next school year. Right, maybe me and Miss Bunch will come have a lunch over there and come and see you guys.
I'm going to middle school east.
I love middle school.
You're going to love it. No, I won't.
You love it. No, none of us will love middle school.
Number four, remember this is completing your homework, so I'm giving you a homework-free evening. But we got to work and focus on this. Okay, number four. Here comes number four. You ready? You had Miss McQuitty.
Yes.
Go tell Miss McQuitty. Say Miss Hackett's not going to make it down to your class.
Okay. Can I go with you?
No, and we need one person to
do it. Miss McCourty's face.
Don't go rub it in, brother. Just walk it down.
And then, Hacker, whenever you get done, they can just move to silent read because it's Tuesday. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. We're just going to do the rest of this, and then, they don't have homework. You're good. And then silent read. They're doing really good at this. You're so good.
I owe you.
No, you're good. Trust me.
Because I know you're on break now or something.
No, I'm not. You're good. I'm not on a break yet. Well, I'm walking out of here in 15 minutes because that's when my break starts. No, I'm just teasing you. I'll stay. Okay.
Yes.
Sorry. Ready?
Yes.
Isaiah, yes. What?
I don't know the
You don't know what?
The what happened in the story.
Number 4?
Yeah, that.
Okay, let's read it.
No,
okay. Oh, well, what's the theme in the story? Be...
Don't take advantage
of others or be...